Sound design.
So in this video, I'm going to show you how to build your own target trace in SATlive. And at the end of the video, I'm going to tell you where you can get a copy of all of my target traces so that you can use them for yourself or steal my ideas, whatever you want to do. So in Windows, you're going to open up the Target Trace Builder, which is this little app that comes with SATlive, and it just runs independently of it. So you don't need to have SATlive running. You can just open it up. I'll tell you guys, the first time I tried to find this, it didn't load when I first opened up Target Trace Builder. So what I ended up needing to do was type in TTB. So if you try to load Target Trace Builder and it doesn't load, try TTB instead. So then that loads this little app, and here we can just draw in the picture that we want. So let's draw in the same picture that I talked about in the last video when we were working with Smart. So I want my boost in the low end to start at about 160, and I want it to get up to 10 dB by the time we get to 100 Hertz. And then I want it to basically stay there until the end of time. And then in the high end, I want my attenuation of the high end to start at about 8K, and I want to get there by about 10 or 12K. So let's get down to maybe 2, maybe 4 dB at, let's say, 12K. All right, that looks pretty good to me. So that's pretty simple. You can get more creative here if you want. There's a bunch of settings up here if you need more range, if you want to do like a 50,000 million dB low-end boost or whatever, and you can change the resolution if you want to get really specific there. Then all I need to do is hit save. Oh, it already had my old one open. So I have this one called Concert Target, and I guess it just loaded that as soon as I loaded this. Now, if I wanted to change the name, I would click Save As. I have a folder of target traces here. So I already have one called Concert Target, but if this were a different trace, I would call it something else. So let's actually make a slightly different trace, so I'll have something different to save and show you. So let's do my corporate events target trace. So that's gonna be something more like a maybe 5 or 6 dB boost in the low end. And that's gonna be, I think, a little bit lower down. And I don't want to kill so much of the high end above 8K. So a little bit more gentle roll off here above, say, 7K, just to not kill people with sibilance. Okay, so just getting up to -2. So everything just a little bit scaled back for my corporate events. Now I can save this corporate target. Save, and now I can just close this. Now I can open up SATlive, and if I hit Shift X, that opens up this dialog. And if I don't want to do that, I can click over here, Edit Target Trace, load that target trace. So let's load my concert target, and then I just need to make sure that this little box is checked, otherwise it's going to show me the X curve. And now when I hit the X key, it'll show my target trace. All right, so it's as easy as that. And then if I want to show a different one, I would go up here, load, corporate, open, close. If yours doesn't show up like this, and you want it to make it look more like mine, then go to Setup, Display. And then I think SATlive usually loads automatically with preset 1, so I switched to preset 2 to have a dark background. Scroll down under Color to Target Trace. Click on that, click White if you want it to be like mine. And then make sure to choose Preset to Use from Preset 1 to Preset 2, and click Save. All right, now when you press the X key, it should bring up a white trace here. And if you want to make that even more thick, you can do that, okay? Or even more thin. And it's as simple as that. That's how you create a target trace in SATlive. Now, if you want to get a copy of all of my target traces, I have 3 that I bring with me to all of the work that I do. I have a general one for concert, corporate, and I have one that I used when I was working on the circus tour for the Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey Circus. And they're all similar. They just have different levels of boost in the low end and attenuation or boost in the high end. So I'll put a link to those below this video. And I would love to see your target trace. So why don't you comment below this video and either send me a link to your target trace, show me a picture, or just describe, you know, the details of where it's at and tell me why it works for you. Why did you discover that this cut here and this boost here work well for you as a target trace, maybe for the client that you have or the kind of work that you do? All right, thanks.
Sound design. Live.